Hello students, I hope you are doing well. Students, please stay indoors and be safe. So with this note, let's start with today's class. So in today's class, I'll deal with poem 1 and the name of the poem is The Wind, as you can see. So please take out page number 16 from your English reader book and we'll read the poem The Wind. And the poet is Robert Louis Stevenson. It is pronounced as Robert Louis Stevenson. So we'll just read something about the poet. So children, Robert Louis Stevenson, he was born on 1850 and he passed away. Means he died in 1894. He was a Scottish novelist and travel writer. Now who is a Scottish novelist? What do you understand by the term Scottish novelist? Children, Scottish means the people who are living in Scotland. Scotland is a country, so the people who are residing in Scotland, they are called as Scottish people. As we live in India, we are called as Indians. Similarly, the people residing in Scotland are called as Scottish people. So, Mr. Robert Louis Stevenson, he was a Scottish novelist and a travel writer. Now, here is the term travel writer. What is the meaning of travel writer? Means a person who keeps on traveling and he writes his experiences in the form of stories or in the form of poems. It refers to travel writer. Means usne bahut sari jagah travel kiya tha and he has written several experiences in a book in the form of story or poem. He is also the writer of famous books like Treasure Island. Children, it is not pronounced as Island. Island is not pronounced as Island. We pronounce it as Island. S is silent. So, the famous books are Treasure Island, Kidnapped and The Strange Case of Dr. Kale and Mr. Hyde. These are the famous books that are written by Mr. Robert Louis Stevenson. So, now I'll start with the poem. So, before I explain you the poem, we have something to read. So, before you read, you must have felt the wind blowing in the sky. Have you ever seen the wind? Definitely there is wind, there is air. If air will not be there, can we survive? Can we live? No, it is not possible for the human beings, for the plants, as well as for the animals to live in the absence of air, in the absence of wind. So wind is definitely there. We can feel the wind. But can we see the wind? Is it possible for us to see? No, we cannot see the wind. We can feel the presence of wind, but we cannot see it physically. So children, in this poem, this poem has been written from a child's point of view. Child's point of view means this poem is written from the perspective of child. What a child thinks, what a child is thinking about wind. Wo child, wo bachcha, wo kya sochta hai wind ke bare mein? How he is imagining the wind. The child wonders how the wind that tosses his kites in the sky has been created. Is it a person or a thing? So this child, since the child is small, so he keeps on wondering that how the wind that tosses his kites high in the sky. Tosses means to move something casually. Means, जब आप kite, आपने लोगों ने अगर kite उड़ाया होगा, तो आप लोग कोई इसका कोई particular direction नहीं होता है कि आप उस kite को इसी position पे रखोगे, वो कहीं भी जाता है. It has no direction. तो उसको कहते हैं casually, means in an informal way. तो किस तरह से हमारे काइट ऊपर आसमान में उड़ते हैं, तो the poet is imagining ये कैसे होता है, विंड के वजह से ये कैसे हो पा रहा है, हम लोग विंड को देख नहीं पा रहे, we cannot see it, but still wind is doing several activities, it is performing different works. So the poet is imagining these things and the poet is also saying he is quite curious to know that how all the activities are taken place. Is the wind a person? Is the wind a human being? Or it is a thing or an animal? Means the poet wants to know the appearance of wind. How the wind looks like. So since the poet, Mr. Stevenson, he has written this from the point of view of child. So aapko is poem mein ek child kya sochta hai, ek bachcha kya sochta hai, उसके ओपिनियन के बारे में हम यहाँ पे पढ़ेंगे कि वो किस तरह से इमेजिन करता है, हाउ द चाइल्ड इज इमेजिनिंग, हाउ द चाइल्ड इज वंडरिंग दैट द थिंग्स आर गोइंग ऑन. So first I'll recite the poem and then I'll explain the stanzas of the poem. I saw you toss the kites on high and blow the birds about the sky. And all around I heard you pass like ladies' skirts across the grass. O wind, a blowing all day long. O wind that sings so loud a song. I saw the different things you did, but always you yourself you hid. I felt you push, I heard you call. I could not see yourself at all. O wind, a blowing all day long. O wind that sings so loud a song. O you that are so strong and cold. O blower, are you young or old? Are you a beast of fields and tree, or just a stronger child than me? O wind, a blowing all day long. O wind that sings so loud a song. So children, this poem has been divided into three stanzas. Now what are stanzas? Children, when you read a story, usme bahut sare paragraphs hote hain. There are so many paragraphs in the story. So when you recite a poem, we don't call those paragraphs, we don't call it paragraphs, we call them stanzas. Hum log story ke time mein usko paragraph bolte hain, and when we are reading a poem, when we are reciting a poem, we call it stanza. So there are three stanzas in the poem. This is the first stanza, this is the second stanza, and then we have the third stanza. This is the third stanza. So now I'll start with the explanation of the poem. Okay, the first stanza. I saw you. So listen, children, before I start this explanation, I'll just explain the new words. Toss. The meaning of toss is throw or move something casually. Casually means in a relaxed way or in an informal way. Means there is no aim, aimlessly. That is called just casually doing something. Blow. To blow means move quickly and loudly. And third is beast. Beast means animal. So these are the new words. Now I'll explain the stanzas. I saw you toss the kites on high and blow the birds about the sky. So here in this poem, the child watches the wind doing things. The poet, means the child poet, I would say, the child poet is describing the wind doing different things, like the wind is tossing the kites high in the sky. Tossing the kites means moving high, means doing something casually. Kites jaise ki casually move karta hai. So that's where the poet is saying that I am seeing the kites flying high in the sky. Then blow the birds about the sky means the poet is seeing the birds, they are flying high in the sky. And all around I heard you pass. The poet can also hear the sound. Children, we can sometimes hear the sound of the wind, the sound of the air when the wind is blowing powerfully with a lot of pressure. Then we can sometimes hear the sound of the wind also. Like ladies' skirts across the grass. Now, what is the meaning of ladies' skirts across the grass? Ladies' skirts across the grass, children, it means that children, girls or ladies, their skirts are till knees, wo knees tak ke hote hain. And when the girls or ladies, they are walking near the grass, then a sound is heard. That sound is called that rustling sound. Wo jab girls ke skirt aur grass touch hota hai, to jo sound aata hai, that sound refers to that rustling sound. The sound that is made. That refers to the rustling sound. So the child poet is saying that even I can hear the sound of the wind, but I cannot see the wind. O wind, a blowing all day long. O wind that sings so loud a song. So children, in these lines the poet has personified the wind. Now what is the meaning of personified? Personified. Children, personified is a figure of speech. Ek figure of speech hota hai. Personified, this word has come from personification. personification. Personification means when you compare a non-living thing with a person. यहाँ पे poet ने wind को, wind एक non-living thing है, उस wind को poet ने एक person से compare किया है. कैसे compare किया है? ओ wind, a blowing all day long, ओ wind that sings so loud a song. Song कौन गाता है? Who can sing a song? Definitely a human being can sing a song. So in these two lines, the poet has compared the wind with that of human being. That like human being, the wind is singing all day long means singing all day long means the noise means the sound that is made from wind, that refers to the singing so loud of a song. And blowing all day long, every day means every time it is blowing. Is it possible that sometime, some or the other time it is not blowing? It is not possible. Every time the wind is blowing. Sometime it is mild, sometime it's strong. So sometimes we can hear the sound and sometimes it is we cannot hear the sound. So this was the explanation of the first stanza. Now I'll come to the second stanza. I saw the different things you did, but always you yourself you hid. I felt you push, I heard you call. I could not see yourself at all. So in this stanza, the poet is saying that he can see the poet doing different things. He can see the poet doing different activities. Now, what are the activities? Like the wind is tossing the kites high in the sky. Then winds are helping, or wind is helping the birds to fly high in the sky. So these are the activities that are done by wind. And sometimes the poet can also feel the strong wind. How he can feel? Because sometimes what happens, the poet feels the push, and sometimes it tends to disbalance him. Sometimes the pressure is so high, the pressure is so extreme, sometimes the pressure is so high, so a person can feel the presence of wind, the pushing of wind. So this the poet is saying, the child poet is saying. But the poet is saying that even though you are doing different activities, but I cannot see you. Even you are doing different types of work. The poet is talking that you are doing all sorts of activities, but still you are hiding yourself somewhere. I cannot see how you look like. I cannot see your appearance. I cannot see you at all. The poet wants to see him physically, but he is not able to see him physically. He can feel its presence, but it is invisible. And again, the two lines are repeated. O wind, a blowing all day long. O wind that sings so loud a song. Next, the third stanza. O you that are so strong and cold. O blower, are you young or old? So here the child poet is saying, and it is trying to know whether the wind is strong or whether it is cold. And then the poet is willing to know the age of the wind. He wants to know whether the wind is young or the wind is old. Are you a beast of field and tree, or just a stronger child than me? Children, beast means animal. Yeah, this is beast. Beast means animal. So the poet is asking the wind, are you a beast of field and tree? Means you are an animal who walks on the land. Beast of field means an animal who walks on the land. Or you are an animal who stays on the tree. So the poet is asking the wind whether you are an animal of land or an animal of tree, or you are just a stronger child as me. You are so me, or the poet is saying that, or you are just a stronger child than me, because I can feel your push when you are pushing me, when you are very sometimes when you are extremely powerful, you are strong, I can feel your push, you tend to move me. So the child is asking the question to the wind, are you just an animal or just a child who is stronger than me? So again the lines are repeated. O wind, a blowing all day long. O wind that sings so loud a song. So even though the poet cannot see the wind, but he tries to know the wind as he talks to him, because he sees things moving because of the wind. So this is just a imaginary poem. This poem is written from the perspective of a child, what a child feels, what a child thinks, what are the questions of the child. So I hope that the poem is clear to everybody. Thank you so much. Eat well, take proper rest, study properly, be energetic, do exercises regularly, and stay safe. Thank you.